Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our service of Worship for All. This morning, we continue with our theme of trust. Our opening sentence, trust in the Lord forever, for in the Lord God you have an everlasting rock. And the greeting, let us worship God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you,
and also with you.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
We will rejoice and be glad in it.
Our opening prayer. Lord, direct our thoughts and teach us to pray. Lift up our hearts to worship you in spirit and in truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Collect. Gracious Father, revive your church in our day. And make her holy, strong, and faithful. For your glory's sake, in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. We come to a time where we say sorry to God for all those things which we wish we had not done or said. God our Father, we come to you in sorrow for our sins, for turning away from you and ignoring your will for our lives. Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For behaving just as we wish without thinking of you. Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For failing you by what we do and think and say. Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For letting ourselves be drawn away from you by temptations in the world about us. Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For living as if we were ashamed to belong to your Son. Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
May the Father of all mercies cleanse us from our sins and restore us in his image to the praise and glory of his name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The reading is taken from Matthew chapter 14, verses 22 to 33. Immediately he made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. And after he had dismissed the crowds, he went up the mountain by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone. But by this time the boat, battered by the waves, was far from the land, for the wind was against them. And early in the morning he came walking toward them on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified, saying, "It's a ghost," and they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them and said, "Take heart, it is I, do not be afraid." Peter answered him, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." So Peter got out of the boat, started walking on the water, and came toward Jesus. But when he noticed the strong wind, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Jesus immediately reached out his hand and caught him, saying to him, "You of little faith, why did you doubt?" When they got into the boat, the wind ceased, and those in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
A response to our reading today. Peter is, without a doubt, my favourite disciple. He's adventurous, impetuous, and he makes mistakes. It is encouraging that he still struggles with his faith, despite having, as we heard last week, witnessed Jesus feeding the 5,000. Peter's faith journey, like ours, isn't a single event. He has to learn to trust over and over, and he is easily distracted. Let's take a moment to imagine the situation Peter was in. First century times were pretty scary. The weather was unpredictable. There could have been wild beasts, invading armies, and uncontrolled political leaders. If you lived in the first century, you had no clue what awaited you around the corner. There was much to be uncertain and fearful of. Today, of course, the opposite is often the case, and we can suffer from a news overload, though the result may be that the dangers also seem constant and overwhelming. So, was Peter brave or a bit crazy to step out of the boat? He was perfectly safe in the boat despite the storm. When the disciples see Jesus walking towards them on the water, Peter says, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He steps out of the boat, out of his comfort zone, and walks on the water towards Jesus. But then the doubt starts to set in and he starts to sink. We can sense the moment when Peter, distracted by the storm around him, starts to rely on his own skills, stops trusting Jesus and begins to doubt. How often are we the same? When challenges and storms come our way, our natural first instincts can be to turn inward and trust our own skills, intellect, money, or connections before we remember to trust God. So, what do you think? Was Peter brave or a bit crazy to step out of the boat? Or did he, by stepping out of the boat, out of his comfort zone and failing, learn something about and therefore deepen his faith? All great learning requires experiences, failures, and repetition. In our culture at the moment, there is a heavy focus on avoiding and minimising risk in response to the coronavirus situation. I know in my day job as a head teacher, my risk assessment for fully reopening school in September is currently about 18 pages long. But I wonder what risks God is calling us to take in our faith, both as individuals and as community. A comfort zone can be a lovely place to be, but nothing much grows there. Let us see Peter's story today as a signpost to put our trust in God and brave a step forward in our faith, both as individuals and as community. Amen. We affirm our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
We believe and trust in him.
This is the faith of the church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord God, we come before you to pray for all those people for whom taking risks is a way of life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our emergency services, paramedics, the police, the fire service, all who daily face difficult situations as they seek to help to protect us and make our world a safer and more peaceful place. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for people who work in troubled areas, the armed forces in war zones, those who bring humanitarian aid in areas of natural disaster, and many more. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for people who take risks in your name, Lord Jesus, those who take your word where it is most needed, and for people who grapple with faith and doubt. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name,
your kingdom come,
your will be done,
on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Blessing, honour and glory be yours, here and everywhere, now and forever. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Our services this week are evening prayer online on Wednesday at 7 o'clock, and Worship for All will be online at 9 o'clock next Sunday the 16th. And we will have services in Thorndon Church next Sunday, Worship for All and Baptism at 10:30, followed by Holy Communion at 11, and Worship for All in Gislingham Church at 10:30 next Sunday too. Have a lovely day, everybody. Stay safe. Take care. Goodbye.